Well, look who stopped by. Hall of Famer Eric Dickerson led the NFL in rushing 4 times. 8th all-time NFL rushing leader. Zeke is holding out. Jerry's punishing him a little bit, by the way. Melvin Gordon, by the way, is also just 1 year out. Melvin Gordon's problem is they have a good backup running back for the L.A. Chargers.
Yeah, he's not Melvin Gordon, though. Let's be for real.
Well, you like running backs to be paid.
Of course. They should get paid. They do the dirty work. We get hit. We play real football, Colin. Real football. Not that pity-pat stuff.
I want to talk. Marshall Faulk said something. I guess he went down to Cabo to talk to Zeke, and he said he's in great shape, but he hasn't gotten hit. And, you know, there's this feeling. Joy and I have talked about this with Le'Veon Bell. There is something to getting hit, right? Like, it does matter?
It matters a lot. I mean, you have to get hit. I mean, I had a 47-day holdout with the Rams, and I don't forget when I came back. I mean, I had 2 days of practice, but you need to get hit. I mean, because when you forget that first hit, it's almost like getting slapped and like, ooh. I mean, it's shot because you haven't had it in a while. You know, the pushing and the pulling. I mean, you have to have that. I think the big thing is the Cowboys like to run the football. You know, are they going to try to ease Zeke into it, or are they going to try to throw him right back in and get right back at it? You know, when I came back after 2 days of practice, I carried the ball 31 times.
Oh, my Lord.
I mean, I still had 150 yards. I had a broke hand, got a broke hand, and hurt my hamstring.
You had all the talent, but you weren't physically ready for it.
No, I was not ready for it. I mean, it takes some time. Even though you think in practice, they don't really hit in practice now, but you still have to get the running, the pushing, the pulling, the blocking, you know. All those muscles have to get stretched out. You have to get used to it. Almost like you have to reset your body to get hit again.
Yeah, Bill Polian, and you make a good point. Practice, they don't hit as much. So the gap between practice and the games is greater than it's ever been. Bill Polian, the old GM, the Hall of Famer, used to tell me, 3 weeks of hitting, and if you get to 2, you will not tackle well early in the season. He goes, your tackling gets worse, and your fumbling goes up.
Yep.
Like, guys fumble more when they're not. You watch it in college football. These first couple of weeks, teams don't tackle very well.
No, they don't.
They don't.
No, they don't.
Let's talk about the Andrew Luck situation. Steve Berline's on later. The initial reaction is, hey, no criticism of Andrew Luck. Over the course of the last week, story comes out that Chris Ballard, the GM, and Jim Irsay tried to talk him into just going on the IR for 8 weeks. You're allowed to do that now. Now, in your day, IR's out for the year. Now the NFL allows 2 guys to go on the IR and just sit around and practice. Is there anything about quitting 2 weeks out as a quarterback that does bother you?
No, not look. This is a sport that's a physical sport. And you know one thing? He said one thing that really resonated with me when he says, I'm done mentally. I'm mentally burned. And I get it because people think it's just about the football, the physicality of it. That is a mentally draining sport. It really is. I mean, he gave his all to Indianapolis. And another thing, you said he could have sit out and they should have still paid him. You got to commend a man that says, I'm not going to take this $30 million just to sit out. I can't do that. I mean, that's a very honorable guy. I mean, most people say, I can get $30 million to play. Oh, I'm cool with that. I'll take that deal all day. So for him, I think in any other job, you want to retire, no big deal. But if it's sports, oh, you're giving up. Oh, it's this. You have life after football. That's what people don't realize. They don't know the pains and the physicality and the headaches and the non-sleep you don't have when you retire. They're not there. Your wife, your mother, your father, they see all that stuff. The fans don't.
So your career was 11 years.
Right.
So when physically did you sense in your career pain was a bigger discussion? The joy was leaving. About what year in 11 years?
You know what? I can say some of the joy left me when I left the Rams. I mean, okay, this is strictly a business. I mean, after like 5 years, this is strictly business now.
So for you, at least mentally, it wasn't just playing football.
Man, let me tell you something, Colin. When I first started playing football, the first couple of years at the Rams, I loved everything about football, the smell of it. I hear guys say, we all say the same thing. I would have played for free if somebody would have paid all my bills because that's how much you love it. You just loved everything about it. Then all of a sudden, you see the ugly side of football, right, the business side. And that's what it is. But after, I mean, I say about year 7 or 8, I'm like, man, you don't heal as quick. You start hurting a little bit more. It's not easy to get up.
That's what I hear from players. It's the body doesn't bounce back.
No, it does not. I won't forget, we played the Cleveland Browns in 1984. The year I rushed for 2,000 yards. And I would go out after every game. Sunday after every game, we'd go to Red Onion after every game. I carried the ball, I think, 31 or 32 times. And that defense beat me up badly. I mean, we won. I had 102 yards on 30-something carries. And they were like, man, let's go out. I'm like, oh, I can't go out. I was only 23 years old. So, you know, your body, it just doesn't bounce back all the time.
Yeah, I was a waiter at the Red Onion there, and really? We were looking for you the whole night. You never...
I was there if you're the right Red Onion.
Okay, so Daniel Jones, preseason's not, it means something. You can't tell me it means nothing, because I saw Dak come to Los Angeles, play against the Rams as a rookie in preseason. We all went, who's that guy?
Yeah.
And he's been very good since. So it means something. Daniel Jones completes 83% of his throws.
That means something.
Come on.
It means something. I mean, look, the Giants are going to have to eventually move on from Eli. I mean, is Daniel Jones the guy? He could be.
I think he has to be at this point.
He'll probably be the guy. I think if you start with him, you have to stick with him. If it's a bad season, you got to just stick with him, because that's how football is now. You know, when I came in the league and guys before me, they'd set a quarterback for 3 or 4 years.
No question.
No question about it. But now they can't because of, you know, the salary situation and also, you know.
He's a number six pick. You're paying him money.
Oh, you're paying him. So he's going to play. I think he's going
to
play.
You know, I tell the story. When I was a kid, I went to college at Eastern Washington University. The Seahawks held camp there. And Eugene Robinson was from Colgate, and I got the media guide as a college student. Mm-hmm. And number 41 was blowing people up. I'm like, Colgate? Eugene Robinson ended up having a great career. So this idea preseason means nothing. Go back to your career. Was there ever a guy you saw in preseason, you never heard of him, and he was from nowhere, and he hit in preseason, and you all went, oh, Lord, we got ourselves a player.
Yeah.
Because you were a star out of college.
Yeah, I mean, I can think of one guy. I was at the Colts. We got a guy named Jeff Arad from Southern Mississippi. And, man, I think something. No, Ole Miss. And he was physical. I mean, very physical. I mean, he's like, y'all can't block me. Jeff was strong. But right now, I used to tell him this. I said, Jeff, stop running into us full speed, you're going to hurt yourself. I said, look, you're on our team. You play for us. Y'all can't block me. I say, what about the other team? So now when I see Jeff, his hands are really, really messed up. Fingers, shoulders. I mean, he got so many problems, beat up. And he said, Eric, he said, man, I wish I would have listened to you. I said, because, I mean, that's what it is. I mean, when you practice, some guys, you know, you just see it right away. You just see how good they are, how good they're going to be. And this guy, to me, Jeff Arad was that guy.
Eric Dickerson, Hall of Famer, led the NFL in rushing 4 times. Andy Reid of the Chiefs will be joining us at the start of next hour. Have yourself a great weekend.
Have a great weekend.
All right. All right, folks, don't go anywhere. Casper has Sleptember, entire month dedicated to the rest and relaxation. Save 10% Casper.com through September 2nd. Hour 2 next.